it's ever changing, and that's the beauty of hip hop music, that the growth has never stopped.
So, Meth, actually, I was thinking about, when was the last time I saw you perform? Of course, we met when I was still at ESPN, and the Wu-Tang Clan was performing in Hartford. A rare treat in that city, trust me, bro. I was like, woo, thank God we got something we got to do in here, and a dope group, a legendary group. But that wasn't the last time I saw you. The last time I saw you perform was when you were with Redman. This was the BET Awards. And you know how The Roots does the Roots and Friends concert, right?
Yeah.
And y'all was on the stage with Thought. So Thought did, he did Redman's Wild the Fuck Out. He did that.
Yes, he did.
I have never heard somebody murder somebody else's song the way he did. Like, he killed that so hard that I remember you took the mic and you were like, I don't even want to come after you after
that. After that shit, like, I was good. Like, Black Thought, he's been doing that for years, man. They even had me go on Fallon one time, and me and him were doing different Wu-Tang songs in between outtakes. And yeah, I just shut up and let him do them by himself. He was killing them shit.
He's probably my favorite, one of my favorite MCs, like The Roots. Like, I was a day one Roots head from 1992. Seeing that special moment with the three of y'all on stage, it was just really, really special. And I love it when they do that, when they bring other people on and y'all just vibe off each other. It's just like really great.
They got a lot of love in the hip hop. They got a lot of love in the hip hop arena, man, you know, because, I mean, just respect-wise, period. They got a lot of love in the hip-hop arena. And Black Thought has always been one of our premier lyricists and thoughtful people, i.e. the name Black Thought.
It all goes together.
Yes,
it kind of reminded me of where I wanted to start with you, because there's so much to talk about, what you're acting, what you're doing on Power Book 2. I love that your character is kind of despised. This is so funny to me. and playing that, and of course, your fitness journey and other stuff. But I wanted to kind of start with rap because, you know, I know you're asked quite often about best MCs, top five, all that kind of thing.
Yeah.
You yourself could be included in any of those lists. But taking yourself out of it, who's a name that doesn't get mentioned whenever we're having this endless best rapper ever conversation that should be mentioned?
Ooh.
Or rarely gets mentioned.
Inspector Deck. Definitely Inspector Deck, man, because Deck has set off some of Wu-Tang's, or ended or been on some of Wu-Tang's biggest records. Cream, Triumph, the list goes on. You know what? They cover a lot of bases, and that top five has been really flimsy lately. You know what I'm saying? And but you have some people that are creatures of habit, and of course the Jay-Z's, the Biggies, the Nas's, and from the next generation, the Kendricks, the J. Cole's, people like that come to mind. But now we got so many new cats coming out. I don't think you can have a top five, really. You'd have to wait like another 20 years in order to like solidify a top five MCs, or maybe just do it annually, I guess, something like that, because it's ever changing, and that's the beauty of hip-hop music, that the growth has never stopped. Even if the artists have, the growth hasn't.
We set ourselves up because it's just people we refuse to kick out of the top five, and it's not, you're not kicking them out because they don't deserve to be mentioned. It's just things change. Like basketball players, we do that all the time. We change the list, right?
We do.
There's going to be some holdouts. Like, a lot of people, like, they ain't never let Michael Jordan go. And I'm not saying that they should.
But and that's,
The fact is, it is a discussion now about, like, where LeBron belongs in that top five. Those change. But for some reason with music, we just don't want to let go.
And you know what? We like to think of ourselves as the gatekeepers. And the reason why people take music so seriously is because it reminds them of moments in their lives. You know, maybe it changed the perspective, or a lost love, or just anything that brings you back to a moment where it makes you think. So, like, and all your inner thoughts just come back, and you either smile or it makes you cry. And that thing there, you want to preserve that as much as you can. So when you hear something that goes against the grain, you tend to think, okay, well, this isn't you fill in the category music. You know what I mean? And it gets to a point where if we all felt that way, there wouldn't have been a Prince, you know, because Prince didn't exactly do urban music. Prince did world music. He could go pop, he can go soul, he can whatever he wanted to do. So where do you put an artist like that if you have gatekeepers that say, no, that's not the way our music is done? No way. So I love
the good thing, I think, where Wu-Tang has an advantage is that we don't see hip hop groups anymore, right? And so we have to be stuck with certain groups. Like, you know, my four favorite groups, but like, they're not changing. It's gonna be Wu-Tang, The Roots, NWA, and Outkast. Like, that's not gonna change because we don't see groups anymore. Why do you think that is? What happened to the hip hop group?
First of all, that's a strong ass list. I think what happened to the hip hop group, Wu-Tang might have happened to the hip hop group, but a lot of other things come into play also. And what I mean by that is Wu-Tang's had a unique record deal. Like when a lot of MCs say they changed the game, it's more of just a saying, it's superficial. But when Wu-Tang said it, it really happened, because when we came in as a group with the option to sign as solo artists. Now, that was unheard of back then, because at that point in time, a lot of record labels did not want to work with other labels. It's basically you're cutting your money in half. And to see this deal actually go through and to have these record labels working together for our cause was unheard of. So now you have these groups that come in as groups, but they want to sign as solo artists, and they're literally coming in asking for a Wu-Tang deal. Like, that's the name of it. And I think that when you do have all these solo artists and you try to come back as a group, you have a bunch of solo artists trying to be a group now, and sometimes the cohesion isn't there, especially if you all didn't grow up together and you were thrown together something like the Spice Girls or something like that, you know? But over time, you can tell who lasted, who didn't. I like the way Lil Wayne did it, because Lil Wayne put together like a Super Friends. You know what I mean? Like a Justice League of hip hop. You know what I'm saying? He got his Wonder Woman with Nicki. He went and got his Superman with Drake. He was Batman, you know what I'm saying? And just started adding all these little elements and things of that nature. And if history shows anything, the fact that these guys are still around is very powerful.
Mm. When you think about what hip hop looks like today, what do you think, or how do you think Wu-Tang Clan would be received if they came out in present day?
Oh man, they'd be like, who do you, we'd probably be looked at like Griselda, because those guys, I think they embody a 90s feel, but with a modern day swagger to it. I take my hat off to those guys, because seriously, like, it was to a point where I get everybody wanting to have a wave and be on a wave. And even I, when I started listening to the music, I was turned off by it at first, but then I started to get it as my kids explained to me, you know, exactly what vibing is and, you know, all the little words that they use now and stuff like that. And I started to get it. It's like, okay, it's melodic. It's basically sing-songy. This is what Old Dirty would have been big at right here. Okay, I get it. But the lyricism part of it is what threw me off. And now, damn, I never forgot the question, really.
Well, I just asked you how you felt like Wu-Tang would be greeted today by today's rap
right. Right, so the lyricism gets lost in the shuffle. So you get a Wu-Tang up in there, and it's a bunch of lyrical guys and things of that nature. You know what? Long answer short, yes, we would be received very well, because nobody has ever seen anything like that before.